They're sitting there at this little mirror. They sit down, do their makeup in front of the mirror. Like, on the floor, it's weird. But they got up, they're like, Dean, what's going on? I was like, oh my God. It smells like protection in here. I said, we're wearing full latex. I said, that's what it is. That's what's going on. I said, next show, I'm doing it. And I did. I played in Melbourne with the tightest pants a man has ever worn. They were jealous. Yeah. Someone said, how are the Veronicas? What are they like? I said, well, I can pick him up under each arm. I said, oh, hey guys. It's a funny story how that tour came about. I met them here in Melbourne behind the show. And I was at the Royal Show and they were doing a thing after I was doing a thing. And they're sitting there. And a friend of mine used to hang out with their guitarist. And I went, oi, Veronicas. They went, huh? I said, you're the Veronicas. And they went, yeah. And I said, do you know, actually, what is her name? Emily. I said, do you know Emily? Cool, little, short, pasty, indie girl, used to hang out with your lead guitarist. Like, they went, oh, we love her. And I said, yes, so did I. But your lead guitarist got there first. So, what do you do? Anyway, they Instagrammed me. Said, we're in Sydney. We reckon you're in Sydney because you're on Channel 7 at the moment. I was like, okay. Like, yeah, you got me. We met at a bar. We were having a few drinks. There's a really wasted guy there come up and he was talking to us. And I was like, this guy's cool. And he's like, man, love your stuff. And I was like, love your face. It's fantastic. It was Daniel Johns. When I found that out, I was like, oh, I'm actually pretty chuffed now. We're sitting there and I said, so you got an album out? I went, yep. I said, so, you'll be doing a tour, won't you? I said, yeah, we're doing it next year in February. And I was like, great, you got a support act? They said, no. I said, I'm your guy. And I was. Business the old way. We haven't rehearsed this. Ladies and gentlemen, Aaron Shembury. Oh, I will be eventually.
Cigars. Well, I know I had it coming. I know I can't be free. I hear that whistle blowing, and that's what tortures me. If they freed me from this prison, then the railroad street was mine. I bet I moved on a little further down the line, far from Folsom Prison. That's where I wanna stay.
That's alright now.